You seem troubled.
Hey guys, ACCast here. Welcome back to some more Super Mario Sunshine. In the last episode, we finished up Gelato Beach, and in this episode, we're finally seeing what that turtle thing is and progressing the story. So, to start off, there are two ways you can go, that way or that way, but I want to show off something really kooky. It'll be the same thing either way. But you see that turtle thing? There's this guy right here. Hi, how you doing?
What's that? Come on. I smell it. Something's going to happen. But where? Where is it?
I'm looking right at it, fella. So, I'm just going to go over there. And right over here. Look at that. We didn't even come from there. Whoa. He's sticking his tongue at us. How rude. And then we know what it feels like to be him.
That is Pinna Island. The villain's secret hideout must be there.
Yeah, no duh. Anyway, now at 30 shine sprites, a giant light will appear in the sky. Kooky. Anyway, that wouldn't have been there if you didn't get, if you didn't trigger that cutscene. A giant, mysterious light in the sky. Beautiful. Anyway, this cannon would not be open if you had come here any earlier than that. So, what do you have to say? Oh, now. Also, all the toads are in here. Anyway, what do you have to say, sir? You want to go out to that island? Alright, then hop in there and cover your ears. Cover your ears, indeed. Get shut into the sky. This is Pinna Park, Episode 1, Mecha Bowser Appears. Now, this is where I think the game starts to get really interesting. We start off with that menacing Mario at the door. Okay, there's not much you can do here at the beginning. There are these guys, you can split them and they're weak. But we're not gonna go that way. We're gonna go this way. Oh, also, I love the sunshine. But oh, is it ever bright? Here, my man, try for my special saves. Cool. Yeah, I'm styling now. So, when you get 30 shine sprites, you can talk to a guy like this, and I'll give you these shades. Basically just lowers the brightness of your game. Not sure why you'd ever want this, but probably on a TV with brightness settings. Anyway, just talk to him again. Take him back to you. I like it better like this. I like games that have, you know, a nice summer feel. This game is really good. What do you have to say? Welcome to Pinna Park! Oh, hi, okay. Hi. Oh, also, there's something interesting you can do. Oh, okay. Anyway, we're supposed to be chasing him. But you can do a glitch. Okay, I can get these guys off my back. Thank you. Okay, so spray some water. Or not. And then what you wanna do is like right when you get here, you want to basically, if you exit the area right here, it'll skip a cutscene. Like, it'll entirely skip the cutscene that's about to happen. However, I'm not going to do that. Because it wastes time. Wastes time? Thank you. Anyway, speedrunning tactics, pretty good. Not going to show it off. Maybe I will some other time. Maybe. But not right now.
Perpetrator, get away.
What a spectacle! This is a new show of ours! You guys are great! Whoever hired you needs a raise! I love how you play the fearless hero, and he's like a bad version of you, where you both look the same and stuff. Well, as director of this park, I want to ensure your success, so how about I provide you with a hero's vehicle? Follow me! And he puts us in a roller coaster. Introducing Mecha Bowser. An interesting boss, in my opinion. He will start shooting both bills at you. From behind. You use Flood to take him out. As you saw, you actually get rockets. Once you get a rocket, shoot him! Shoot him 5 times, and I think that's when he's down. At least I think it's 5 times. Anyway, you can also come from the
how's it going?
Anyway, if that fire's there, just hit him, and then stop breathing. Or, what you can also do is, put it up water. We're already doing really well. Now, this roller coaster mechanic will come back later as kind of annoying level in my opinion. But anyway, one of the main bosses. I don't think we're able to describe this guy. He's big. That cutscene is pretty cool, by the way. So it was only 4 times. I was wrong.
Mario!
Oh! How rude. Wait a minute. What's that?
Leave my mama alone, you bad man! I won't let you take Mama Peach away!
Mama? Mama Peach? I'm your mama?
Yeah, Papa told me all about it. He told me my mama got kidnapped by a bad man named Mario.
So you're Bowser's son?
So I came here to rescue her.
So the graffiti... that was you?
This is my magic brush. When I draw with this, all my wishes...
Didn't even answer the question.
A strange old man in a white coat gave it to me.
A strange old man in a
white coat. I wonder who that could be.
But why would you pretend to be Mario?
Papa told me everything. He said,
Mario's a bully, he never fights fair.
He said,
Junior, you gotta try to outsmart Mario.
So I tried to get Mario sent to prison, but they didn't lock him up, and now he came to steal Mama Peach again.
Yeah.
You pest! Stop following us!
Yeah.
Amazing backflip. Uncle Ian.
No, not again. It appears to be heading toward Corona Mountain.
Of course. That's all done. We get our shine sprite. So, I have a lot to explain about that. That was Bowser Jr. He made his first appearance in this game. He is actually Bowser's son. Not the Koopalings. They are not Bowser's son. Or Bowser's... Not Bowser's children. Thank you very much. Been confirmed by Mr. Miyamoto. Anyway, let's talk to you. Outstanding! Breathtaking! What a tour de force! Perhaps it'll inspire word of mouth to draw more visitors. Okay, also, this game is believed to be a prequel to Luigi's Mansion, even though Luigi's Mansion came out before this. Two reasons. One, the man in the white coat is actually Professor Elvin Gadd, commonly known as Professor E-Gadd. If you don't know who that is, search it up. I don't have time to explain. Yes, I do, but it would be better if you just search it up. The next part about this being a prequel is that it's later. Or, yeah, I'll talk about it later, I guess. Anyway, that is where we're headed, Corona Mountain. All we have to do is beat episode 7 of every level, and then... Yeah. We go back to Pinna Park. Again. To start a new level.
Sounds exciting.
Pinna Park, episode 2, The Beach Cannon Secret. Let's get right in. This is another secret level, if you were wondering, by the way. Get a nice view of some dude. So this guy will launch bullet bills at you before you get close enough. He can launch three types of bullet bills. Purple bullet bills, basically like homing missiles, black bullet bills, and just go in one direction. In rare occasions, you can throw gold bullet bills, which if you spray them, they drop coins. When you get close enough, they'll have these bombs. Throw the bombs at them. First spray them, they'll throw the bombs. They'll have to do like a direct hit three times, then he's down. I'm actually pretty sure that there's like some way that you can like, cheat the system almost. Like, you can, if you go fast enough, you can slide and like go through there if you jump. It's really weird. But then it'll just take you right into the secret level. Anyway, this guy meets a horrible death. This Ken's just like the one that Phenoplasm. Yeah. Anyway, let's hop inside. Select this mission. Oh, we just met you. Also, you can't skip those cutscenes, but I just like to do them. We get sort of a Yoshi's Island feel. Oh, we have some Yoshi blocks. And we've been talking about Yoshi lately. I wonder what that tells us. Anyway, there's these blocks here. They will start to turn dark, and after a while, they will disappear. Some crate here, some coin, a one-up mushroom, also one-up mushrooms. If you fall down, you come over here, and there will be little spawners who spawn this enemy. Which is why you want to come over here? You don't get coins. But anyway, it's telling us, hey, go up. If there's not any other way to go, bounce on these orange bouncy things, and then, gotta go fast, Nick, seriously, you want to go fast, but I recommend sliding a lot. Sliding most of the time. You can get that one up, but I don't recommend it. It's kind of hard. I see a lot of things are hard. Anyway, this wasn't too hard, I guess. And I guess I'll skip to the red coin part of this. I wouldn't say it's the easiest red coin mission in the world, thanks to these blocks and not the most amount of time. I'm really messing up my word choice today. Anyway, I just want to point out that Pinna Park unlocks a lot of stuff for us to do. Like, it unlocks new levels, it unlocks a bunch of power-ups. Just really good for mapping stuff. Anyway, we already got 6. I don't believe it. Anyway, here's our 7. And then the last one is right over there. Faster. Okay. It's a good thing we don't have to go all the way to the end. That'd be anyway, let's grab our shine and move on. I'd say we got time for about one more. Sounds good. At least I think so. Pinna Park, Episode 3, Red Coin of the Pirate Ships. Another red coin mission. Now, this is where we can, finally start to actually go in the park. Just a sec. Oh, that was weird. I didn't even go in. Anyway, we have a nice view of these pirate ships. That's that pie. So, anyway, this park is a nice, peaceful place. Big things of pirate ships. They'll basically try to make you fall off. Excuse me, that's a glitch if I ever saw one. Anyway, there are red coins scattered about. Some of them aren't even on the pirate ship. This is red coin of the pirate ship. Sometimes, these ships will even go round and round. Let me get the red coin. There we go. got it. No!
Yay.
Oh no! Oh my goodness! I'm terrible fate, haven't I? Anyway, I'd say the best thing for me is go up here and do the Ferris wheel. And there's that roller coaster track. It all comes full circle. Anyway, yeah, as you see, not all of these are on. Where is that? Hello? Yeah, not all of these are actually in the range of the pirate ships, I guess you could say. I'm using this gate mechanic again. Oh, Grand Pouncing Gate Fall Damage. Oh, and here's the other type of button I was talking about. The gold button. Not sure the next one for. Ground pound it, and coins will appear. And timer starts, and the time runs out. No, you don't die. Not sure why I needed those, but, you know, it's just nice to have, I guess. Oh no, the bridge is out. I wonder how I should get across. Anyway, we have these guys here. They're on this side, down. They're on the other side, press A and focus. And I also let me grab onto this. Get up in here and take it. Get on, please. Oh, I'm using the wrong button, that's why. Silly me. Anyway, that's 5 coins. 6 And then up here. And then up here. And then something interesting. We go on the other side. And then press A, smash these guys. One of the red coins is right here. One more. You could just vault over these guys. There's the red coin there. And there's the final red coin. And something I really like about this game, I'm about to show it to you once I start to go up. First of all, I believe we can use that tactic thing. Ooh, save me. What a save. No. Oh, nice. Anyway, what I want to show, that's one thing I want to show, but anyway, look, it's just like, it looks like that these little hexagon plates just aren't moving, they're just going along with you. Anyway, find a red corner, right at the top. Good place to put the shine sprite. Rinse, wash, repeat. Anyway, let's just get our shine sprite. No more dilly-dallying. I actually think I've got time to show one more thing, and it's a pretty well hidden secret. I'm not sure how people were supposed to find this on their first try. But, I'm gonna fly all the way over here. Let's up the roundabout. Come at this. Visit the beach and spray around, you'll hear a little spark. What about you? And it's your shine sprite. Didn't see that one coming, did you? Anyway, he'll go all the way over there. Oh, look, there's a pipe over there. I don't know if you've seen that. Anyway, I just can't get this shine sprite. Pretty nice secret hidden shine sprite. I this myself. I had to find a tutorial to get this one. Anyway, 40 shine sprites. One third of the way done with the game. I think that leaves off a good point to end the video. So, we started Pinna Park, did more of the story, visited Bowser Jr., did some nice stuff, got some shine sprites. Got some good shine sprites. Next time on Super Mario Sunshine, that's the one, we will possibly finish Pinna Park, knowing my luck lately. Or either that, or we'll do more Pinna Park. See you guys next time.